It all started with an idea. Can you take on multinationals who have been controlling the food system for hundreds of years? Can you instead offer a product that empowers small producers selling directly to the United States? Is it possible to have a model that can create a system that promotes biodiversity and that promotes a completely different way of doing business that's based on human connection and offering a quality banana, but also something so much more? When you see bananas on the shelf, the only thing that might be different is a sticker from your point of view. There's a story there, there's people behind it. The reason why we're here today is because enough people cared in order to make that a reality.
Equal Exchange is really a coffee company. We branched out into other beverages and then chocolate products, but we had no experience, and some would say no business, working in produce. We decided to take it on, first because we're a little bit crazy like that, but secondly because the mission of what we were trying to accomplish with bananas exactly matched who we are and what we're trying to do.
Antes de ingresar a Lazo Guavo, nosotros estábamos pues en otras empresas. Nos decían a $1 la caja y nosotros teníamos que aceptar. Algunos compañeros colapsaron económicamente, vendieron sus fincas y quedaron prácticamente en la miseria, quedado. Y era debido pues a la inestabilidad de los precios que nosotros teníamos. Nosotros como pequeños productores estábamos muy apretados económicamente y nosotros no teníamos dinero para pagar pues a nuestros trabajadores, porque usted sabe que los trabajadores pues ya trabajan y ellos necesitan tener sus ingresos para poder también ellos sobrevivir.
Multinational banana companies like Chiquita and Dole and Del Monte control the entire supply system from the producers all the way to the stores, the price of bananas, and what consumers get. And we knew that there are thousands of small-scale banana producers in Latin America that have no choice about who to sell to. And we decided that our model is to provide market access for small producers and to create an alternative system that would treat the banana farmers fairly, with dignity, and let consumers in the United States know who these growers are and the price that they deserve.
Buenos dias. So here we are in El Guabo, Ecuador, visiting El Guabo, the co-op we've been working with for 10 years. Here with Four Seasons, a distributor, and Moms, a retail location. So basically we have everybody in the supply chain here with us, from producers to co-op to importers, distributor, and the grocery store. So excited to just see what connections we can make together here.
Today we're going to go see the plantations and packing operations and meet some quality control people in country and see some growers that are involved in the small farmer co-ops, and I'm really excited to see how they interact with the fruit and all the passion that they put into the ground and all that good stuff. So really excited for this trip.
Cuando Aso Guavo ingresó al comercio justo, fue muy importante, porque con el comercio justo nosotros hemos obtenido muchos beneficios, como en lo que es la educación para nuestros hijos, porque nos apoyan a nosotros en salud, en educación para nuestros trabajadores. Es decir, pues, todos los apoyos que nosotros recibimos en Aso Guavo son totalmente incomparables pues a lo que antes nosotros pasábamos.
The Equal Exchange model is definitely possible. We've been a supporter of this program for over 10 years, and as the buyer of the fruit, I take a lot of pride in the fact that we can give back to the social community and help provide a premium on the product that makes a difference in people's lives.
La situación antes era un poco, ¿cómo te digo? No había esa tranquilidad que hay ahora con ASO Guavo. Entonces, ahora estamos seguros del precio que se mantiene todo el año y uno puede exportar todo el año a un mismo precio.
Ahora con el precio justo que yo tengo con ASO Guavo, que uno firma y le dice, bueno, todos los jueves tú vas a cobrar a tal precio, está bien, perfecto. Yo vengo y a mis empleados no me falta el dinero y les doy el dinero que tienen que cobrar. Como antes era, que todo el mundo trabajaba por el día. Ahora tú les enseñas a tus trabajadores a que trabajen es por el amor a la tierra.
Las mejoras para nuestras vidas, digamos, son diversas, porque aquí hay un bono escolar a los hijos de cada trabajador que le da la SOGUAVO. Digamos, nosotros aquí, toda la gente que está aquí se siente satisfecha con el productor, son buenas personas, cuando queremos alguna cosa nos ayudan, en ese sentido son excelentes, excelentes personas.
Yeah. Es un placer conocerle.
El placer siempre será mío.
Pero gracias. It's really great getting to meet him because I like when he talked about his son. You know, this is what we kind of hope that it really elevates the society, you know, not just the owner of the farm. So that's really what we're here for, to see, you know, to verify.
I think the interesting thing with what's going on here is that these folks, especially the small-scale farmers that we visited and talked with, it's so interesting all of the different challenges that they have to overcome on really a daily basis as well as an annual basis. Everything from too much rain to not enough rain to, you know, like when to bring crops, like when to try to bring the bananas in to harvest to get the maximum profit that they can get. Like all of that is just really fascinating to me.
And it takes some strong relationships to actually, you know, organize small growers. It's not uncommon for us on a container ship to get 10 different growers in one container of fruit, which you never see that with the much larger organizations. So we're truly supporting small farmers with every load we buy.
The process here compared to back at home is kind of the same, but they go more detail. They're more towards the farmers. For us, we just have to make sure that specs of length, the age of the product, the latex is pretty good condition.
Es muy agradable tenerlos aquí, ¿no? O sea, la cadena completa. Estamos en un punto donde estamos lo que es calidad de campo, calidad en un centro de acopio. Y están también las personas las cuales reciben la fruta, ¿no? Estoy viendo que también aquí está la persona que encargada de la maduración. Entonces, para nosotros, por lo menos para mí, es muy agradable tenerlos aquí a todos y completar así la cadena y conversar sobre algunas falencias que puedan haber en el proceso.
Conocer a los exportadores sería, ¿no? Y ahora que están hablando muy bien de mi producto, estoy emocionado. Tengo que llegar a casa y contarle a mi papá, a mi mamá, porque como les dije, vivimos de esto. Esto es lo que nos da de comer toda la vida, desde que soy un niño. Entonces, yo nací en esto, o sea, yo toda la vida. No sabemos más que exportar banano.
Since this was my first trip outside of the States, it's definitely been very eye-opening as far as just the way people live, but mainly that no matter where you go, that if you, you know, purvey a certain type of good energy towards other people, they're gonna show that love and support right back. I've always had a lot of pride at, before I even met any of the producers, but now that I've met the producers, I'm just gonna take that energy into a whole new level and make sure that that is something that we really push to our staff, the importance of how hard these people work and what a change they really are trying to do, especially with so much competition in the market.
The passion that farmers put into the ground is so infectious, and that for me as a buyer of produce is super exciting.
I certainly hope that the sustainable model is possible. I mean, we only support equal exchange at this point. We really, really love the equal exchange model, and we certainly want to continue that for as long as possible.
For me personally, because I love and have loved working with farmers for so many years, it's just great to get to meet with folks that care so passionately about the products that they grow and could sense the excitement that they had in the relationship. And I already knew the excitement that I had in the relationship. And so kind of like linking all of that up, I think like Moms is a big relationship company. And so that's why we work with Four Seasons. It's why we've chosen to work with Equal Exchange. And so kind of like bringing Aso Guabo into the mix is just kind of like another layer that is pretty badass.
¿Qué espero de esta hermosa plantación? Sea un botón de oro en medio de toditas las bananeras y más que todo para mí y para mis hijos.
¿Por qué prefieres venir aquí?
Digamos que aquí hay otros tratos, primeramente. Productores que no a uno lo tienen todavía como el trabajador. Aquí no, aquí como al amigo.
Empezó con una idea. ¿Qué pasaría si se pagaría los precios justos para todos los productos